G'day, it's Gary from GP Performance. Today I've got a Mitsubishi Triton with the roof faded, so we're going to sand it back, respray it. I'll give you a look at it. Yeah, as you can see, it's in a pretty bad way. We'll sand it back, 240 grit, put some primer down, and then spray some new color and clear.
Something never comes, never leads to nothing. Nothing satisfies, but I'm getting close, closer to the prize at the end of the rope. All night long, I dream of the day when it comes around and it's taken away. Leaves me with the feeling that I feel the most. Feel it come to life when I see your ghost.
Yeah, so after sanding we found that there's a few little rust spots, surface rust under the paint bubbling up, so we'll hit it with some rust converter and it'll eat it away. Yeah, so I'm going to use the Super Cheap Auto's rust converter. I find it works well. It's just as easy as a paintbrush in a container and just dabbing it on. Dabbing it on and letting it dry. A couple of hours it should be all converted or be ready to prime.
Okay, so it's been about 3 hours. The rust converter's done its job. It's converted all the rust. I'll give you a look at it.
Yeah, so all that rust is now, surface rust has now been converted back to normal metal. Just in the bare spots, I'll give it a quick epoxy primer, let that flash off, and then we'll go into high build.
Yeah, so it's day two of the Mitsubishi Trident roof respray. Yesterday we got it sanded back nice and flat. We've put high build primer down. I didn't film the high build primer stage. It's pretty straightforward. I'll give you a look at it. So yeah, there's the roof in high build. We'll throw some guide coat down and get it nice and flat, and then we'll put some base coat and clear coat down and we'll be done.
Righto, now comes the most exciting part. Wet and dry sanding to get the high build primer nice and flat. We'll throw down some guide coat, which will show us the highs and lows of the roof. And once we get it all nice and flat, we'll move on to base coat and clear coat.
Yeah, so I've blocked half the roof with the guide coat on and got it nice and flat. I'll give you a look and show you what the guide coat's for. So you can see where your highs and lows are. You need to sand it until you get the roof flat. So as you can see, that's where I've sanded and that's where I haven't. That's what the guide coat does. If you see there, you can see like little bits of the guide coat in the paint. You need to sand that so it's nice and flat. Once you've got it nice and flat, then you're ready for clear coat and base coat. I'll get back to the most exciting stuff again, sanding. Yay!
Been searching for something, something never comes, never leads to nothing, nothing satisfies, but I'm getting close, closer to the prize at the end of the rope. All night long I dream of the day, when it comes around and it's taken away, leaves me with the feeling that I feel the most, feel it come to life when I see your ghost. Then I'm done, done, on to the next one, done, done, and I'm on to the next one, done, done, and I'm on to the next.
Yeah, that's 2 hours of solid sanding. Sanding's fun. Everyone loves it. Not. That's why I had a little victory dance at the end, because it was over. I'll give you a look at it. Yeah, so I've blocked it down to 800 grit. Nice and flat. You've got to have it flat, otherwise you'll see all the highs and lows. Put in the effort now and it'll give you a better result. We'll just grab a Scotch-Brite and run over the edges here and around the window and the rear window. Then we'll set up the booth and we'll move on to spraying. Yeah, so we'll move on to scuffing up around the drip molds and the front and rear windscreen with some grey Scotch-Brite and some scuffing paste. Yeah, so while we got clear coat mixed up, we're going to re-clear the headlights. After a while, the UV rays from the sun, they'd make them fade and that. I'll give you a look at them. Yeah, you can see the fading of the headlight. You sand them back and give them a coat of clear and they come up like new.
You know you make me break out, make me break out.
Righto, so I'll give the car a quick wash down, get all the sanding dust and primer dust off it. Then we'll set the booth up and move on to spraying. Yeah, so 4 hours and a change of shirt later, we're ready to spray. It's all masked up, ready to go. Here's a look at it.
got the front mast up as well, but I'll spray the headlights at the same time.
Yeah, so I'll turn the background noise down and I'll do a voiceover here. You don't need to hear the noise of the spray booth. So the colour we're painting is colour code JG. It's a granite quartz brown. I had the colour mixed up at VG Auto Paints in Sydney. They colour matched it for me because the colour of the car is a bit faded, so they tinted the paint to suit. So we're just giving it a good tack rag before laying our first coat of base coat down. It's very important to use a tack rag. It gets all the dust and dirt sitting on top of your primer or base coat before you lay another coat down, otherwise you'll see it in the paint. So the spray gun I'm going to use here today is a DeVilvis GTI Pro Light. It's got the 1.3mm fluid tip in it. Settings on the gun is 4 turns out on the fluid needle, fan wide open, running at about 2 bar or 30 psi. Yeah, so this is the first coat of base coat. First coat I like to just dust it on, just get a bit of coverage over the primer. Then your second and third coat you'll lay a lot wetter. It was a hot day when I was spraying this. It was about 44 degrees in the booth. So it was really drying really quickly, which isn't ideal, but we got it done. Yeah, so the brand of base coat I use, it's the Concept 2K base coat. So you mix that 1:1 with a base coat reducer. It's a solvent based base coat. It's pretty good. It's not relatively expensive. It's a good cheaper brand base coat for your normal everyday car. It's ideal. Your higher end show cars, you probably want to go with something like House of Color paints or something like that. But yeah, for an everyday driver, Concept paints works really well. So I end up putting down 3 coats plus a drop coat of base coat. First coat, like I said, was just dusted on. The second and third coat were put on pretty wet. And then a dust coat is where, you know, you just spray your paint from a little bit higher. Being a metallic car, it helps the metallic paint stand up, and you'll see in the end how good the metallic stands up on this car. So this is the last coat of base coat. As you'll see here, giving it a tack rag before applying the paint. You can just see the overspray that sits on the paint, as you can see just there where I'm wiping. Yeah, so it's important to tack rag between coats. You only tack rag between coats of your base coat. You don't tack rag your clear coat. So I'll put on some music for the rest of this stage and I'll talk to you when we start putting some clear down.
this is the base coat, all laid down nice.
Let's see if we can get an off the gun finish and not have to polish it. Alright, I'll see you back up on the tripod and we'll start clearing.
Alright, so here we go with the first coat of clear coat. The clear coat I've chosen to use is Concept MS100 clear coat. It's a pretty good clear coat, very user friendly. Clear coat is fairly thin. So your first coat of clear coat, similar to your base coat, you will just want to dust it on. That'll give you a second and third coat something to bite into. Once you get that first coat down and it flashes off, it goes really sticky, so your second and third coat you can just smash it on and get it nice and thick, get a real good flat finish. So after this coat I'll show you the final coat, and we'll go from there. I'll leave you with the sounds of the background noises of the booth. Enjoy. Here's the final coat of clear coat. You can see it can go relatively slower because you've got your previous coats down and this coat will adhere to the last two coats. I'll throw some music on and talk to you in the end. There goes my hero, something there.
Alright, so it's all finished. Came out pretty good. Probably going to need a cut and buff. There's a little bit of orange peel in it. It's so hot today. It just dried a bit quicker than what I'd like. So yeah, but we'll fix that with a cut and buff. But yeah, it's come out pretty good. Thank you.
Please comment, like and subscribe for regular updates and more videos. Once I cut and buff it, I'll make another video and show you that. If you're interested in getting your car done, give us a call.